If you make YouTube videos, you should keep a copy of all the videos that you upload to YouTube, just in case something happens to your account, or in case one of your videos gets corrupted by YouTube, which has happened to me a few times. But in case you haven't, there are two ways to download your videos from YouTube to save a copy of them. There's one way, which has been around a long time now, to click on this arrow here and you select download MP4. The advantage of that is it's very convenient because you just pick the video you want and you click on that and you get your file. The disadvantage of this method is that you don't get the same file that you uploaded to YouTube. You get the compressed copy that YouTube is streaming to viewers, which is a much lower quality than what you uploaded. But there's another method you can use. It's called Google Takeout. You go to google.com/settings/takeout, and you can create an archive of any of the Google services you use, including YouTube. And with this method, you can download all your YouTube videos. The advantage is that you get exactly the files that you uploaded, so there's no loss of quality. The disadvantage is that you have to download everything. You can't pick and choose what you want to download. So in my case, it gave me a 68.3 gigabyte archive of all the videos I've ever uploaded to YouTube on this account. Well, actually, there's a few exceptions to that, which I'll show later. You can choose either a zip file, which splits it into 2 gigabyte segments, or you can choose TGZ files, which each segment can be up to 50 gigabytes, but unless you have a very good internet connection, I don't know if I would trust downloading a 50 gigabyte file, because knowing my luck, the connection would screw up at 49 gigabytes, and then I would have to start all over again. So I would rather just do it in 2 gigabyte segments like this, which in this case, I have 35 segments to download here. And once you do that, and you look into one of those zip files, you find a whole bunch of your videos. Now, there's no particular order to them. I think what it's doing is it's trying to find an exact amount of files that adds up to just below the 2 gigabyte limit of a zip file, so that way it can pack the files most efficiently. So you get a random assortment of your videos in each one of those archive files that you just have to go through to find whatever video you're looking for. And you notice there's some HTML files here. Now, these are for the videos which have content ID matches on them. In that case, Google does not let you download the video. It just gives you this HTML file explaining that due to the content ID match, you can't download it, and it gives you a link to dispute the match. So that's the one exception. You can't download videos which have content ID matches, not even using the download MP4 link that I showed earlier. But otherwise, you do get all your videos in the same format that you uploaded. Although for some reason, all the files that I uploaded as MOV files are being renamed to MP4. They're not being re-encoded, they're just being renamed for some reason, but it's no big deal. You can just rename them back to MOV if you want. And there are some videos I uploaded back in 2008 and 2009, which I did not save a copy of, which is why I'm using this. So hopefully I can go through all the zip files that I download and find those old videos and save a proper copy of them. And you get 1 week to download all the archive files, and each file can be downloaded 5 times. So it's not a permanent solution for keeping an archive of your videos online, it's just a temporary thing so you can download your videos. The other exception to getting back the original file you uploaded is if you used the YouTube video editor, such as to combine multiple clips into one video. Then you get all those clips in one file, and it is re-encoded, but it's better quality than what they stream to viewers, such as this file here, which I used the YouTube video editor to combine multiple clips, and the file I got from the archive. It's kind of weird. It's using a very old video codec, Sorensen Spark, otherwise known as H.263, which became obsolete in 2005. But at least they're using a very high bitrate, 19.5 megabits. And the audio is actually MP3 at 256 kilobits. You can actually see they used LAME 3.98.2 to encode the audio. So it is re-encoded, but it's better quality than what they streamed to viewers. And here's one of those old videos that I did not save the original file when I uploaded it. It's from May 2008, and you can see I used Virtual Dub to create it. The DMB1 video codec is the proprietary motion JPEG format that the Matrox video capture card I used at the time was using. And I actually captured it as a PAL format. And the audio was just regular uncompressed PCM. So it's nice to have that original file back. And here's a good example of the difference between what you get from the archive and what you get from the download MP4 link in the video manager. On this one, you can see the original file I got from the archive is 216 megabytes, while the download MP4 version is very highly compressed and it's only 8.3 megabytes. So obviously, if you're going to re-upload that video, you really want to use the original file instead of the download MP4 version. Then you'll get much better quality.